Hello, welcome to Cornerstone Church's Bible study. I'm Pastor Steve, and I'd just like to talk to you briefly today. I've noticed a lot of people during this coronavirus pandemic stressing out and acting very negatively and saying evil things and hurtful things. I'm sure you have too. One thing I've noticed, though, during bad times such as 9/11, such as the time we're going through right now, is that there are always people who excel in doing good things. They just go over and above the call of duty and do nice things for people. And you know, they might be donating food, clothing, money, sewing masks for first responders and others. They really get creative and industrious by doing this. And, you know, God brings good from evil. That's His specialty. He brings good from evil, and we should be looking, since we're children of God, we should be looking for ways to bless others, even those who are negative. Let us speak life into them. I titled the message today as Ministers of Grace. And I took it out of Ephesians chapter 4, the very end of the chapter, verse 29 and verse 32. Let me read that to you. Let no corrupt word proceed out of your mouth, but what is good for necessary edification, that it may impart grace to the hearers. And be kind to one another, tender-hearted, forgiving one another, even as God in Christ forgave you. Now the Greek word there, in verse 29, that we translate as corrupt, is sapros. It means rotten, bad, worthless, harmful. And it's the same word Jesus used in Matthew 7 when he said, a bad tree produces bad fruit. Have you ever bitten into a piece of rotten fruit? You know, on the outside, I've had an apple before. It looks beautiful, something you'd polish up and leave for the teacher. And you go take a bite of that, and on the inside, oh, it's all brown and rotten and pithy, and it tastes terrible. You're looking for a place to spit. You know, the outside appearance belies what's inside. I'm a salad eater. I love salads, and these days, grape tomatoes are very popular because, you know, if you cut up a tomato, put it in your salad, and if you can't finish your salad, they tend to make everything else mushy overnight. But grape tomatoes, they stay firm in there, and it's good. Now, I don't cut my grape tomatoes. I throw the whole thing in my mouth, and I've bitten down on some that are awful, and, you know, if you're amongst company, what do? Jump up, run to the bathroom, get rid of that stuff. Awful stuff, bad fruit, not a pleasant experience. Jesus declared that out of the abundance of the heart, the mouth speaks. And just like that fruit, you could be all polished up on the outside, looking real good, but on the inside, your heart could be full of bad things, and that's what might come out of your mouth during stressful times. Rotten words. Tasting rotten fruit's very unpleasant. But even more unpleasant are destructive words. Once these have been heard or read by others, it can't be erased from their hearts. You can't take them back. You know, Proverbs says, death and life are in the power of the tongue. And so let's speak life and not death into people during times like, in fact, all the time. That should be what a Christian does. Now, I've heard many stories about customers in the, you know, buying essential items, supposedly, in these stores that remain open. They're being downright rude and nasty, argumentative, because they can't get their way or buy the things they came in to buy. My wife told me last night, actually, and this is why I'm doing this message today, the subject of the message, is she has two supervisors there that are really nice young ladies, and they were so upset by some customers here yesterday that they had to shelter in an office so they could cry together because the words just crushed their spirits. You know, these ladies were trying their best. They're doing and following the orders of their superiors and of our government by denying people to buy paint and other things. Whether you think that's reasonable or not, it's their job, and they're only doing their job. But they were very hurt, and they had to hide so people wouldn't see them crying, and so they could gather themselves. Well, maybe you've been looking to do some nice things for others, but maybe you don't have the resources available to donate money, food, or masks, or clothing and such. But you know, we all have a resource for doing something good, and He is the Holy Spirit. The Spirit wants to produce good fruit in us. You know, love, joy, peace, patience, kindness, faithfulness, goodness, gentleness, self-control. Maybe I left one out, but these are characteristics of the fruit of the Spirit that the Lord wants to born in us. These things, if we season our words by the fruit of the Spirit, we will build others up. And let me conclude with this. Philippians chapter 4, verse 8, just so many great things in Philippians, but this is a great verse that we can all concentrate on and believe for and meditate on. Paul's writing, he says, "Finally, brethren, whatever things are true, whatever things are noble, whatever things are just, whatever things are pure, whatever things are lovely, whatever things are of good report, if there is any virtue and if there is anything praiseworthy, meditate on these things." You see, when we meditate on these things, we hide these things in our heart. They become part of us, and they will season our words. They'll be gracious words. They'll be words fitly spoken. It'll be words that build others up and not tear them down. There'll be words of life to them. So let me challenge you to be a minister of grace during these difficult times. Our world really needs that. Let me pray for you. Father, help us. Season our words with grace and kindness. Help us, even to those who are rude to us or too angry toward us. Lord, let us be a blessing to them. Let us overcome evil with good. Holy Spirit, help us to do that for the glory of your name. And we pray it in that wonderful name of Jesus. Amen. I'm going to turn it over to Minister Rob, and he's going to sing a song for us.
Amen. Well, thank you, Pastor Steve. Great word for us today. Let's sing "This Is Amazing Grace."
The power of sin and darkness, whose love is mighty and so much stronger, the King of glory, the King above all kings, who shakes the whole earth with holy thunder and leaves us breathless in awe and wonder. The King of glory, the King above all kings. This is amazing grace. This is unfailing love. That you would take my place. That you would bear my cross. You laid down your life. That I would be set free. Oh, Jesus, I sing for all that you've done for me. Oh, who brings our chaos back into order? Who makes the orphan a son and daughter? The King of glory, the King above all kings. Who rules the nations with truth and justice and shines like the sun in all of its brilliance? The King of glory, the King above all kings. This is amazing grace. This is unfailing love. That you would take my place. That you would bear my cross. You laid down your life. that I would be set free. Oh, Jesus, I sing for all that you've done for me. Oh, worthy is the Lamb who was slain. Worthy is the King who conquered the grave. Worthy is the Lamb who was slain. Worthy is the King who conquered the grave. Worthy is the Lamb who was slain. Worthy is the King who conquered the grave. Worthy is the Lamb who was slain. Worthy, worthy, worthy. Oh, this is amazing grace. This is unfailing love. That you would take my place. That you would bear my cross. You laid down your life, that I would be set free. Oh, Jesus, I sing for all that you've done for me. Yeah, Jesus, I sing for all that you've done for me. Jesus, I sing for all that you've done for me.
Amen. Be blessed, church.